total trivia ownage. I got a plan, and it's to get the belt.
Lon, we have a terrible problem.
Oh, well, what is that? What's amiss?
Sorry to interrupt your contemplation, but I've been sending JTE numerous telegrams, and he has not responded to me.
No. Do not worry about JTE. I assumed long ago that there was a chance that Snape might betray us once more, betray our trust, get onto another vehicular transport that he could not control. I knew that he might depart before we had a chance to enter the tournament, but I have taken the liberty of finding a new partner for our association, my colleague Simon.
I can't actually read.
Now, you recall my recent sojourn to Northern Europe?
Yes, of course. You were checking out the Flemish countryside.
So a scholarly walkabout to the Flemish countryside as I sojourn every few years. During my sojourn, I encountered Simon here. He informed me we were colleagues, we were roommates back in. Was it Oxford or Cambridge?
Oxford and Cambridge at the same time.
Oxford by Cambridge.
Oxford by Cambridge.
You hyphenate.
Oxford by Cambridge.
Right, it's like Stratford-on-Avon.
3 whole years, you didn't look at me once.
Well, I was deeply lost in contemplation, as I just was right now, staring. I ruminate, I gesticulate. This is part of the scholarly life. I apologize.
Yeah, well, you know what they say, 3 out of 8. I don't know
the rest of
if
that?
They say that.
I don't. I've never said that.
3 out of 8.
Who's they?
Them.
Right. Got
yes.
It. Popular British parlance, I'm assuming.
Ibid opsit them. Mm-hmm. Got it. Right.
Good. Then I'm happy you have a new partner, and I will continue to manage this team the best way I know how, but
please.
Perhaps we should change for the evil geniuses, since that was a JTE construct, to something more supreme, as it were, something with sour cream.
Hmm. We shall think about it. What would people of such supreme intellect as us call a team?
That's I'll have to think about it, and I'll get back.
You know what you should do? Ruminate on it.
You're doing a marvelous job.
Yes,
you're
wonderful.
Doing a marvelous job.
Wonderful work on everything.
He's terrible. Who is
yeah,
he?
Yeah, he is my brother, but I quite agree with you. Rather than getting offended by this, I'm going to agree with you and say
well,
yes.
Well, I'm your brother now.
He's doing a terrible job. I shall call Mother and let her know.
Give my love to Mother.
Cheers.
Welcome back to the Movie Trivia Schmoedown. The singles tournament continues, and what a tournament it's been so far. I'm Christian Harloff, joined by Mark Ellis. Mark, how you doing?
I am baby carrots around these parts, Christian. And, you know, I love a good playoff format. I love a good tournament setting. That is what we have in the Movie Trivia Schmoedown. It's the ultimate Schmoedown, like you said, the singles division, and we have somebody who we've known for a while can answer a lot of movie trivia questions. Then we have someone who we haven't known as long for a while who can answer a lot of movie trivia questions. Going to be quite a clash here today.
But what an impact. You're talking, of course, about Liz Shannon Miller at 3-1. She battled at the Collision in the number one contender match against the now champion, Primetime Paul Oyama. So she already has been battle-tested. We know that she is a worthy competitor, and she's here now in her first tournament. Now, that can always be intimidating, but she played at the Collision in front of thousands of people watching, thousands
live.
Of a bunch of people here. And on the other side of it, she's staring at Ben the Boss Bateman, who has had a bit of a rough season. I mean, he's had a rough season. When you look at it, Ben Bateman is touted to be like the next big superstar. What Ben Bateman has been able to do so far in this league, his studying has been mimicked by other players. He won the team's tournament last year. But this year, he lost to the Odd Couple in Chicago. He was supposed to he had the big match against Andrew Guy that he won in Houston, but then against Mike Kalinowski, he loses that and loses his opportunity to go to New York. So the Horseman and Ben are reeling right now.
Yeah, Ben's legacy, it's really a question of are you going to be known for a guy who was able to win a lot of matches or maybe a guy that set a new standard in how you prepare for matches? Because a lot of people, like you said, that came into the league this year, look at how Ben Bateman prepares, but did they elevate from him or can he continue to be? And the top rung. And for Liz Shannon Miller, like you said, she played Paul Uyama. She played very well against Paul Uyama. She is not intimidated by a guy that wears sunglasses.
No, it doesn't seem like it. But we also know that the winner of this match plays Paul Preston. And you talk about a guy that's just rising up as a superstar.
Powder
right now.
Keg, big fan of whey protein, that guy.
He is 3-1 right now. And he's waiting in the wings. Not an easy task right now for either one of these competitors, whether it be Ben Bateman or Liz Shannon Miller. But that's what the tournament's all about. This tournament already, this is the tournament that started this entire league. So this is a big match. This is one of the last matches, and we're excited to have both Ben and Liz Shannon Miller. And talk about Nerd Chronic, the best promo guy in the biz. He put it together to show you how we got here. Here we go.
Obviously, you're 3-1 now, but you're going to be in the singles tournament.
My first Ultimate Schmoedown tournament. I don't know what makes it more ultimate than all the others, but it's been a fun ride so far, and I look forward to discovering what comes next.
To say the horsemen are underperforming would be the biggest understatement in the history of understatements.
The horsemen, we've struggled a little bit recently. I think it's obvious to see, but there's a full half of the season left, right?
I'm not going to lie to you guys. I'm a little frustrated. I played badly in that match. I'm not going to deny that.
Would we have loved to have been in New York against Paul Uyama? For sure. But we're coming.
I think Ben Bateman is never going to be a guy that gets too down on himself, and he's got a great set of teammates to pick him back up.
That's behind me. I don't want to worry about luck. I don't want to talk about losses. All I want to talk about is winning.
Him and Roker are the only guys we got in this tournament. Riley's gone. Earl's not in it. I like our chances.
Losing the last match was my first loss, and so I didn't know going in how that would feel, and now I know what it feels like to lose, and it doesn't rule. But I'm just coming in, no expectations. I'm just here to have fun and play a game, and I'm feeling really relaxed and calm.
It's a great opportunity for me to go in there and remind you guys of who I am, who the boss really is, and what it actually takes to be a real competitor in this game, to be a real professional. That's what I'm here to do.
My approach has always just kind of been slow and steady, and also trust my base level of knowledge and not let nerves get the best of me.
In the old days in this league, you could miss 5 or 6 questions and win a match. It's not like that anymore. Your first round opponent, they're a 3-1 person who used to be in contention for a title. That's the truth. That's the reality. I'm not walking in here thinking this is a cakewalk anymore. I got to go in there and I got to show her it's about trivia, and it's about gameplay, and it's about attitude.
We're serious this time.
I'm going to say this, Nerd Chronic, much better than Chronic Tacos.
Oh, yeah?
No longer in business across the street. No longer in business.
Makes sense. That'll give you some gas.
Rubalcaba, big fan of it. Me, not so much. We came to blows almost.
Oh, yeah. It makes sense. Okay, listen. So this is a match that we know, they both know a lot is on the line. And I think that Liz Shannon Miller is actually the one who seems a little bit more relaxed, a little bit more calm, as where Ben Bateman said it as much in the pre. He's frustrated.
Well, once you get to this place and you've been here before, you feel like you have pressure on you to continue to do what you have done or what you've been touted to be able to do.
Right.
Liz Shannon Miller, you come in here, it's the playoffs. Yeah, if she knocks Ben Bateman out, I think Ben Bateman feels like he has more to lose right now than Liz Shannon Miller. But the winner, like you said, is going to continue to evolve in this playoff. Offseason.
All right, tale of the tape. Here is the tale of the tape.
What are they good at?
You have Liz Shannon Miller, who is good at directors. You have Oscar movies and being able to really make that hat look incredible.
Good at wearing hats. The best hat wearer since Dick Tracy.
And there you have Ben the Boss Bateman. Oscar movies, movie release dates, and being able to stop Tom from getting arrested.
He was the best sunglasses wearer since Mark Harmon in Summer School.
Nice.
How do you like that?
That's a good reference. Yeah. I like it. All right. With that being said, Mark, we're ready to start this match. How about you?
Yeah. Well, you said we, so I guess you're answering
for me
now.
Well, we, collective we.
No. Go ahead. Answer all my questions to the camera.
Perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Movie Trivia Schmoedown.
Playoff atmosphere, you can feel it in the crowd. There's something in the air tonight.
Introducing first. Sometimes I get this feeling deep down inside. With a record of 3 wins, 1 loss, and 1 knockout. She is Lightning, Liz Shannon Miller.
There she is.
Look at that shirt.
There's the hat. very Carmen San Diego. Where in the world is Liz Shannon Miller? She is ready to compete.
She's ready to compete. The question is her opponent?
Ooh, that's a droid shirt she's got on that. Is R2-D2 the best droid in the game?
And her opponent. And we have Liz Shannon Miller, Ben the Boss Bateman. Mark, round number one.
What yep. are the rules? We got rules to round number one, Christian. I'm about to read them right now. This is the singles format. It's a playoff, but it's going to play out like a normal match as far as rounds go, because in round number one, you're going to hear eight questions from eight different corners of the movie Trivia Schmoedown Galaxy. Each question is asked to the field. It's worth 1 point. As soon as you hear the question, please write down your best attempt at an answer on the whiteboard in front of you. You have about 15 seconds to complete that task. And then once we address you by name, please reveal what you wrote on the whiteboard legibly as possible to the camera. At the same time, you verbalize your answer into the microphone. There is no penalty for missing a question. There is no stealing available in round number one. Each competitor has three usages of the JTE rule throughout the duration of the match. If you're not sure you heard a question, you need to buy yourself some time, another 15 seconds, please use a JTE rule. You also each have one challenge to be used throughout the duration of the match. Christian, I'm not sure if it was captured on camera or if they were running the rules card during my reading, but it was nice to see a handshake, a gesture of sportsmanship.
It's all about
Ellis. I'm a nice guy.
let's not get crazy with the words here.
We'll see. All right. So, with that being said, the rules have been read by Mark Ellis. We'll start with Ben Bateman. Are you ready?
Absolutely, Christian.
Liz, are you ready?
Let's do it.
Then let's get ready to Schmoedown. First question.
Have at it.
First question, category number one is fantasy sci-fi. Fantasy sci-fi. Which comedic actor plays futuristic talk show host Ruby Rod in The Fifth Element?
All right, so you love science fiction. If I say name a science fiction film, what's the first movie? Because I know it's not Star Wars. You call that space opera fantasy.
Inception.
Inception?
Five.
Is your science
four,
fiction? I thought you were going to go with three.
Crow. Two. One. Pens down. Ben.
Say Chris Tucker.
That is correct. Liz.
Chris Tucker.
1-1.
All right, they're on the board as we move on to your next category in round number one. That is from the world of crime movies. Crime films. Your question. Who plays FBI agent Adam Frawley, who is pursuing Ben Affleck's character in The Town?
I am an FBI agent.
That's what I think of every time.
Every time.
Yeah. Oh, God, what a great, best action movie of the 90s.
I don't know about that, but it's definitely, it's up.
What would you put above it?
Five. I'm counting. Four.
The Rock is up there.
Three.
Die Hard 2.
Can you repeat the
there.
Question, please?
Yes, you can. Yeah.
Who plays FBI agent Adam Frawley, who is pursuing Ben Affleck's character in The Town?
I do like that town.
Charlestown.
Yeah.
Charlestown.
The town.
Yeah.
And?
Christian, just
five.
Waiting.
Four.
5 second count.
Three.
No banter.
Two. One. Pens down, please. And we start with Liz.
Totally blanked. I'm guessing the actor who played Coach Chandler
Coach
Friday night.
That's a great guess.
Good guess. Ben.
That would be Kyle Chandler, but I'm going to say John Hamm.
John Hamm is correct. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so 2-1. 2-1. But Liz, using that JTE rule well there, let's get her thoughts as we get to the next question here. Next question. Dramas. Jeremy Irvine stars as Albert in this 2011 Spielberg film, which was set during World War I.
You ever been to Irvine, California?
I thought you were going to go with the improv.
Did you ever do the Irvine improv back in the
many times.
You know they remodeled it. You know what the food is?
Chicken wings.
Umami burger.
Oh, I like that. Five.
Four.
That's a good place to tell jokes.
Three, two, one. Ben Bateman.
Warhorse?
Yes. And Liz?
Warhorse.
There we go. 3-2. 3-2.
Warhorse. People seem to criticize it. I loved it. It was
it
a 5 out of 5 schmoes for me.
Catherine Reitman didn't like it.
Action adventure movies. It was not right for her. That's from her show. It's from her show. Action adventure films is your next category. The question, David Leitch directs Charlize Theron in this 2017 action film about an undercover MI6 agent. What's cooler to say at a bar, that you're an undercover FBI or undercover MI6? MI6 is cooler, right?
Yeah. Unless you're Keanu Reeves. 5. Four.
I'm an undercover.
3.
MI.
2.
G. Agent.
One. Stop that. Liz, Shannon Miller.
Atomic Blonde.
Yes. And Ben.
Atomic Blonde.
There we go. 4-3. Bateman Miller. Going ahead. It's a good first round match so far.
Early in the match. Still early in round number one. Well, we're halfway through. Ben Bateman throwing a perfect game so far. Your next question is in the world of animated movies. Christian, tell us about it.
Thank you so much. You almost stole my question. Then you thought better of yourself. animated.
Showing the wizard behind the curtain.
In Brave, how many brothers does Merida have?
Okay, do you have a ranking for Brave?
It's fine. Low.
Is it a? It's a Pixar.
It's low.
Is
yeah.
it a Pixar?
Yeah. Yeah, it's low. Yeah. 5.
I was with the movie for
4.
A while.
Yeah.
And then this
3.
Whole bear swap happens.
2. 1. Pens down, please. And we start with Ben.
2.
Incorrect. Liz.
3.
Yes. Tie game.
It is 3.
Tie game. Ben missed his first question, and now
also
we have a tie.
Bear, the bear stuff
the
in that movie ruled.
The bear stuff? I do like the bear stuff.
It's great. It's a funny bear movie.
Your mom's a bear. Let's figure it out and move on.
Our next question.
All right. Your next question comes from the world of comedies. They're so well trained.
I know you got them.
Your question is, who plays Chris Farley's father, Big Tom Callahan, in 1995's Tommy Boy? Now, can I deliver that question as 1995's classic Tommy Boy?
I think it's a classic.
I think it's
a modern classic.
Ah, you're going by Schmoedown Wheel.
That's right. 5.
Top 10 funniest of the
4.
90s?
It's up there. 3, 2, 1. Pens down. Liz.
Brian Dennehy.
Yes. And?
Brian Dennehy.
Here we go. Tie game still. Look at this. 5-5. What a matchup so far we have as we get to question number 7. Horror/thriller. Horror/thriller. Who directed the 2013 horror smash hit, The Conjuring?
All right, controversial opinion. So Brian Dennehy was an answer, right?
Yes.
That's my favorite Brian Dennehy movie.
First Blood.
The answer is FX2.
Oh, it's a good one.
Because a clown beats up a dude.
Isn't that FX1?
No, it was FX2 with the clown.
5. I'm thinking of Poltergeist. Yeah. 4, 3, 2, 1. Pens down. Ben.
James Wan.
Yes, Liz.
James Wan.
Tie game. Wow, what a battle.
That's right.
What
they
a
know
battle.
Their stuff.
Yeah. There we go. Last question.
Well, keep that applause coming, crowd, because our last question, round number 1, is a Patreon question. John Patterson. Up to bat. Thank you, John Patterson, longtime patron. If you are not yet a Schmoedown patron, check out which tier is right for you, the Movie Trivia Schmoedown Patreon. John Patterson wanted the category of directors. These are people behind the camera, like an RB3 type. And your question in the world of directors from John Patterson, competitors, is which Irish filmmaker has helmed the Shakespeare adaptations, Hamlet, Henry V, and Much Ado About Nothing? So anyway, the clown is like radio controlled. There's no, it's not an actual clown.
I feel
it's
like I remember
radio
this.
Controlled,
yeah.
And he's using the remote control, and it's actually beating up an intruder. Would it happen in real life? I say yes.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Liz.
Kenneth Branagh.
Yes, and Ben.
Kenneth Branagh.
Tie
Kenneth Branagh.
7-7. What a first round between both Ben Bateman and Liz Shannon Miller as we get to round number 2. It's the wheel round. This has either made or sunk careers here in the Movie Trivia Schmoedown, the wheel round. How does that go, Mark?
The wheel has emerged courtesy of our own Alex Marzonia. Is he in love? Is he out of love? You never know with that guy. On the wheel, you're going to see 10 different slices from 10 different corners of the Movie Trivia Schmoedown galaxy. Also on the wheel is what every competitor hopes for, Spinner's Choice, and what the fans love, Opponent's Choice. Once you settle on a category, you're going to hear 4 questions from said genre. Each question is worth 2 points. However, if you're not sure the answer, you can ask us for multiple choice. We'll give you 4 options, one of which is, in fact, the correct answer, we promise. Keep in mind, competitor stealing is available. in round number two. Christian, back to you with the weapon.
All right, so only Liz Shannon Miller has used one JTE rule. She has two left. Ben has all three left. Both have their challenges. Ben Bateman, you are the higher-ranked competitor. Would you like to go first or second?
I feel courteous today. Liz, why don't you go right ahead and spin the wheel?
Sure thing, bud.
You know what? He said he was a nice guy. I doubted him up top. Yeah. It's starting to win me over a little bit.
Big spin here. There's the spin.
All right. Liz Shannon Miller taking a spin.
Spinning the,
open to advance.
The Knight's Shield. Mixed bag.
Okay, stop the mixed bags.
Mixed bag.
Now, does she want to use her mulligan, or does she want to keep mixed bag? Could
it's
be anything.
It's a doozy. It's a doozy of a category.
Could be anything.
Gonna keep it.
Keep it mixed bag.
Hold it. All right. I got it.
All right.
All right, mixed bag. Mixed bag. And here we go, Liz. We don't know what's going to be in here, so here we go.
Reach your arm deep in there, Christian. What'd you pull out?
All right, question one. This actress played Marilyn Monroe opposite Eddie Redmayne in 2011's My Week with Marilyn.
Michelle Williams.
Yes, for 2 points.
Hey.
Okay.
Paying off so far.
Question two. Susanna Fogel directed this 2018 raunchy comedy.
Multiple choice, please.
Is it A, Blockers, B, Life of the Party, C, The Spy Who Dumped Me, D, Game Night?
That would be C.
That is correct for 1 point.
Yes, it is. Spy Who Dumped Me.
That is
We've
right.
all been there.
All right. Question three. What European country did Serpico move to after retiring from the police force?
Okay, I'm going to go multiple choice on that one, too.
A, Germany. B, Switzerland. C, Greece. D, Denmark.
C, Greece.
That's incorrect. Ben, is it A, Germany, B, Switzerland, C, Greece, D, Denmark?
Switzerland.
For 1 point. That is
wow.
correct.
Ice, right. water in his veins with the steel.
Right. Question. Liz's fourth and final question. Okay. What year saw the release of The Day After Tomorrow?
2009.
That is incorrect for the steal.
Ben, for a 2 point steal, this could tie it.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Repeat the question.
What year saw the release of The Day After Tomorrow?
Two JTE rules remain for each competitor.
5, 4, 3, 2.
2002.
It's incorrect. 2004.
2004.
All right. So that is that's the end of that particular
that phase
line
of
questioning
two.
For
yes.
Liz Shannon Miller. Still up by two as Ben Bateman now goes up to spin. It is 10-8. 10-8. Liz Shannon Miller with the lead here over Ben Bateman, and he's
going
to spin.
That's right. The mixed bag call. You know, I don't hate the idea of going to mixed bag. Maybe get some more surface level questions from a variety of categories.
Yeah. There's the spin. Sounds like a dump truck coming down the road at 2 in the morning.
I enjoy the sound of the wheel. It gets the crowd locked in. Almost.
Choice. Denzel Washington.
Denzel Washington.
Denzel, what's he going to do? Is he going to spin it again, or is he going to stay with it? His manager coming out to give some advice.
Denzel Washington, famous for his role in Game Night.
We're going to give a countdown in 5, 4, 3, 2. Gonna keep
gonna
it.
Keep
okay,
it.
Here we go.
All right. All right, Ben, your question. Number one of four. Who sang the theme song, Streets of Philadelphia, for the film Philadelphia? For 2 points and a tie.
5, 4, 3. 2.
Bruce Springsteen.
It is, in fact, the Boss.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Oh, hey.
The Boss.
He's the Boss. Bruce is the Boss. Tony Danza wants to know who's the Boss. All right. Ben, your next question. Second of four in this category of Denzel Washington films. Denzel Washington stars alongside Bob Hoskins in what 1990 comedy about a dead lawyer whose ghost teams up with a cop who has donated his heart?
I love this movie. Did you ever see it?
I literally think you wrote this question as a joke.
No, I swear. I love it.
Underrated movie. Five.
Four.
Multiple choice.
I can provide that. Is it A, heart attack, B, heart condition, C, heart valve, or D, heart donation?
Heart condition.
Give him a point.
One more
point. Give him a point. Maneuver his way around multiple choice.
So now Ben Bateman takes his first lead here as it is now 11-10. Excuse me, second lead.
All right, Ben. Your penultimate question in this category. Who played Dr. Betty Shabazz in the Denzel Washington-led drama Malcolm X?
Start to feel the intensity in the room here as we get closer and closer.
Yeah. Glad neither competitor has a heart condition.
Five, four, three, two.
Angela Bassett.
2 points.
That is.
Ben Bateman jumps ahead now by three, and we move on to one more question, his last one in the world of Denzel Washington movies. This could give you as much as a 5-point lead going into round number three, Mr. Bateman.
That'd be a good lead.
In the film Two Guns, Denzel Washington and Mark Wahlberg must work together despite being undercover for separate agencies. What government agency does Denzel's character Bobby work for?
Five, four, three, two.
The DEA.
I don't know how he knew it, but
he did. Wow. Big pull by Bateman. And now Bateman sees himself with a 5-point lead going into round number three.
Healthy lead.
It's a healthy lead, but it's certainly many, many players have come back from 5-point leads as we get into round number three. And it is the last round here. Mark, how's that go?
In round number three, each competitor is going to give us a series of numbers. These numbers can range from 1 to 20. We need three numbers from each of you. The first number is going to correspond to your 2-point question, whatever category that may be. Your next question is going to be worth 3 points. Your last one, should we get that far, is 5 big points. Mr. Bateman, not only are you sitting in that chair, you also have a 5-point lead. So you can give us your series of numbers first. From 1 to 20, we need three numbers that feel lucky to you.
Punk.
Mr. Punk.
Oh. Let's go 3, 7, and 17.
3, 7, and 17 for 3, 7, and 17 for Bateman. Okay, and for Liz.
14, 15, and 16.
14, 15, and 16.
I like that.
Liz.
Nice,
I like
tight,
it too.
Compact.
All right, so Liz is going to go first here. She's going to try to avoid the TKO as we start with category 14 for Liz. And Liz, you chose comedies. Oh, there you go. That's
not in round three, that's right. And Draco.
That's right. All right, here you go.
Somebody get Andraco out of the studio. Security.
Liz, this mockumentary about beauty pageants and the lengths that some contestants will go to win stars Kirstie Alley, Kirsten Dunst, and Denise Richards.
You had me with mockumentary about beauty pageants, Drop Dead Gorgeous.
Correct, on 2 points. All right.
All right.
All right. So, so now your 3-pointer to tie the game is rom-coms. Rom-coms. Here we go. Drew Barrymore and Adam Sandler find themselves stuck together in an African resort for families in this rom-com. Five, four, three.
Repeat the question, please.
Absolutely. Second one. Drew Barrymore and Adam Sandler find themselves stuck together at an African resort for families in this rom-com.
Blended.
Correct. What a way to play the game there. She took
That's
her time.
Right.
You saw it, and she used it. Good uses of JT, and she's tied the game. Now we bounce to Ben Bateman, who now has to hit his 2-pointer.
He's got to hit his 2-pointer, and if he does so, he's going to have a 2-point lead over with Shannon Miller, who would then be forced to answer her 5-point
right.
question. Ben, in order to do that, you need to get this question right in the category of, remember Blended?
Yeah, I remember.
Drew Barrymore.
Oh, look at this.
Drew Barrymore. And your question is, Drew Barrymore plays the character Dylan Sanders in what action franchise?
Five, four, three, two.
Charlie's Angels.
2 points, and he's back in the lead.
All right, so now Liz Shannon Miller has gotten herself out of TKO range, but now she has to hit her 5 to stay in the game. If she does, it bounces back to Ben Bateman, who will have a chance to tie the game. with his three. But here we go. Liz, you chose category 16. You chose crime films. Crime films. Here you go. Who played the role of J. Edgar Hoover in 2009's Public Enemies? Five, four, three, two, one.
Comini, I don't have it.
And your winner, advancing to the second round, Ben, the Boss, Bateman. The answer was Billy Crudup. Billy Crudup was the answer. Billy Crudup.
Well, there's a lot of famous historical figures in Public Enemies. Yeah. It's a tough five-pointer, but that's why they call him the five-pointers. Ben Bateman will move on in the tournament, but a great display.
Great display.
A wealth of knowledge by both competitors here, Christian. Liz Shannon Miller coming up a little short there. Yep. But she played a good game. I think that she's learned how to strategize around all three rounds at this point.
It's funny. Even with the loss, I think this is the best she's played the game.
Mm-hmm.
She took her time. She you could tell even with that three-pointer, she just relaxed and she hit it. And she played a hell of a game there against Bateman.
But you talk about a master strategist when it comes to playing the game, figuring your way out around a board. Ben Bateman, perhaps one of the best we've ever seen at the Strategy Incorporated, despite the fact that he was walked out by Tom Bagnino.
Listen, he's playing on the ropes right now, and he knows he's playing on the ropes, and he's at a point that he's got to just – everything counts. But it's now he's got Paul Preston, which is not easy. He had Liz Shannon Miller in the first round. That wasn't easy. Mm-hmm. And now he's going to have Paul in the second round, two rookies back-to-back. But these are rookies that are coming to play. And like I said, Liz Shannon Miller just showed she's learning the game better and better. She's going to be dangerous every time she's out there.
She played fast. She played loose. You're right. She played like she had nothing to lose. No. Unfortunately, she took the L, but we're going to see her back real soon.
Well, she is backstage now with Jen Sturger, who is with Liz. Let's go there now.
Thank you so much, guys. Oh, Liz, despite the outcome of that, I feel like I'm watching you learn how to play this game and you're getting better at it every single time from a strategy standpoint. How did you feel out there? A little more comfortable?
Yeah, I think so. I think the honest truth is, like, I'll confess, like, going first in the wheel round always throws me a bit. Like, the first three matches I won, I went second on the wheel round. And so now I'm back to this, like, oh, maybe the superstitions are going to kick in and, like, all that jazz. But
not supposed to put that stuff out there for your enemies.
I know. I'm very bad at this game. But I did have a really good time today. I felt really good about getting the ones I got right. I don't feel bad about getting the ones I got wrong. Like, that's, I think, the biggest thing for me is there have been questions I've gotten in this tournament where it's just really, you know, killed me that I've missed it, that I knew that one back and forward. The movies I got questions on today, you know, I just wasn't that familiar with, and you can't be familiar with every movie on the planet, as I'm sure everybody who participates in this competition is more than aware of.
Oh yeah, absolutely, especially when you land on something like Mixed Bag.
Yeah.
You know, it is what it is.
Yeah, I mean, my philosophy towards the wheel round, I mean, despite my just talking about superstitions just then, has always just really been like, you know, with the exception of, like, if I know I can't do something, like, take what I get, because, you know, then you never know what kind of questions they're going to be. Like, even in the most difficult, like, as I saw in the JT match I did recently, you know, he's a big Ridley Scott fan. That Ridley Scott round destroyed him, and I felt really bad about that because I have been there, I'm sure.
Take your time, go to multiple choice, limit the amount of damage your opponents can do. These are all just things I'm throwing out there for someone who just sits back and will never play a match ever. But so, I mean, what is next for you? Obviously, this is the end of your journey in the tournament, but we're hoping you come back next year.
Yeah, I mean, just whatever happens next, I hope to have another opportunity to play.
We'd love to see that.
All right, thank you.
Congratulations again on your season, and sadly, it ends here.
All right, like Jen just said, Liz Shannon Miller is getting better and better at the game, and I think, as we have already found out, that you know, there's going to be a lot of people, I think, looking at Liz Shannon Miller to say, oh, maybe I want her to play with me.
Invaluable experience when it comes to getting into a tournament setting in general, having that extra added oomph of pressure to you, and then playing against a guy like Ben Bateman, where if nothing else, you are going to pick up some strategy points just by watching how he plays the game.
Right.
So Ben Bateman is a guy that you can look at, and the question we asked at the top of the show is, Ben Bateman just the guy who sets precedence in how to prepare, or can he actually get questions right still? He proved that today.
Well, that's right, and I'm sure, and Jen, I know Jen will ask him also about the fact that the Horsemen, and now you had Riley. It looked dire, because Merle had lost the title. Riley gets bounced in the first
round. That's only eight horsemen left, according to Tom Dagnino's count.
But now we have Ben Bateman, who has the victory, and now he's going up against Paul Preston. Very interesting to see what's going to happen here. And Jen, take it away.
Thanks so much, guys. Mr. Dagnino, you've got to be feeling pretty good. The horsemen have been having a really rough run as of late, but I feel like there's a little bit of an upswing right now.
Yeah, we're back in the saddle again, and the horse has nothing to worry about because I'm only about 6% body fat now. So here's what needed to happen. Ben needed to win. And guess what? He did. Look, like I said earlier in the pregame, with the horsemen, we derailed. Our horses were in the stable, but now they're coming back out. It's gonna be the Kentucky Derby and the Belmont Stakes and the other one.
So many horse references there. Ben, how are you feeling after this match? Obviously, you know, you watched Riley lose. You watched Dan lose his belt. What does this win mean to the horsemen?
It's a good win, Jen. I mean, you know, I went out there. I felt a little tight when I walked in, to be honest, but I just had to play it quiet, you know, and I look over at Liz, and I think Liz is a really talented player. I think she knows a lot about the game. It's arguably she knows as much, if not more, than I do about movies. I've seen her matches, but I was gonna stare at her while she was answering her questions. I was gonna be a part of the game. I'm not trying to be a mean guy. Just I gotta win this match. I gotta play it serious, and I take this stuff seriously. So I was very happy to go out there and win. It felt really good, and it's just one step closer to resurrecting what's happened to this incredible stable that I was fortunate enough to be invited to join. So,
do you think you just had an upper hand on her for the fact that you do know how to play this game better than most?
Yeah, I mean, there's little things, you know, if you could have heard some of the stuff Gucci and I were saying to each other between the rounds or...
I'm glad I didn't.
yeah, the stuff he said was, I mean, next level. But anyway, the point is just kind of crunching the numbers, exactly how many points we needed, how many we could afford to give away, things like that. I was a coin flip away from a TKO in that match. Two brothers versus three, 2002 versus 2004. It's just that stuff in your brain where you can't quite lock in, but it's fine. It went in my favor in the end, and I played a tight game. I was happy about that, so.
Well, coming up next, no slouch. Oh.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. I can't hear those generic responses. And I think I also heard them earlier today when the Seattle Mariners lost. Those are like from Baseball Player Handbook 101. It's time for new blood, pal, okay?
You know, if the boss went to college, he would have beaten up guys like you. That's the reality. So he didn't go to college. He was self-educated. But thanks for walking in my interview.
I was just going to insult you that you didn't go to college, but you did it for me. Listen, I'm glad you made that poll on Bruce Springsteen, because that answers a question, who's the boss? It's clearly Bruce Springsteen, all right? It's time for new blood, all right?
You're wearing a Wimbledon visor from a garage sale. Like, be honest with yourself. I'm a nice guy, but you're pushing me a little bit.
Dude.
I don't have enough mics back here.
I got this at the premiere, okay? I got this at the premiere. And besides, I can't even hear you behind those sunglasses.
Yeah. I know. They're loud, as intended. Now get out of my interview, okay? I'll see you in a couple weeks.
You will see me in a couple weeks, pal. Everybody show up for the exit strategy that he's got for leaving the tournament, all right, when he takes on the powder keg. Everyone's talking about the powder keg. No one's talking about Bateman anymore. No one's talking about you. You know they're talking about? They're talking about Jason Bateman. More than talking about you.
No one can hear you because you're not mic'd. Jesus.
Your Velcro's undone on the sandals. All right, never mind.
I think he's got to go manage Prestige Worldwide or something. Anyways. Best of luck to you going forward in the tournament. God help us all. It's over, buddy. Just this interview's done. Back to the desk.
Well, I mean, that was a lot.
A lot of information. Paul Preston wears flip-flops with Velcro. Interesting decision.
Interesting. Well, God bless Jen Serger that she was able to maintain all that. But look, the powder keg is no joke. I mean, he's getting to this point. Like, this is what happened last season when Ethan Irwin came on the scene. You know, he had a strong first part. But or you know what? A better reference, I think, would be Mara Kanopic, right? So Mara Kanopic, towards the second half of the season, really dominated and wound up winning Rookie of the Year. Paul Preston, it was Paul Preston month at one point to where he had so many different matches and he's fighting and he's now becoming a name for the Schmoedown community. People know and he's becoming one of these Schmoedown pros now that people really want to see compete.
And now you have Bateman, who used to be the new blood, who is now turning into one of these, you know, kind of vets. And he's going up against this guy, the powder keg, now in round two. And that's a match.
But my question is Paul going to be able he's good with the words and the verbal jabs backstage when he's not competing.
Right.
But is he going to be able to replicate what I think Liz Shannon Miller is able to do today, where you come on and you're loose, you're ready to play, you're not too panicked, you're not nervous. She came, she played her game, she played well. Can Paul Preston do that in a tournament setting against somebody like Ben Bateman? It's going to be a lot of pressure on him. Interested to see if he can live up to the hype.
Same here. And this match definitely lived up to the hype because you had, once again, Liz Shannon Miller had a really nice run this season, 3-2 overall, and she went up against Ben Bateman, who's looking to make a statement and try to win this tournament. So you guys, what do you think? We're asking once again, make sure that you comment and like. We're doing a little challenge here today. Let's see if we can get it up to 2,500 likes and over 600 comments. That's the challenge for you guys today. Go ahead and tell us exactly what you thought of the match. Join the Patreon. If you haven't had a chance to get your tickets to Orlando.
Orlando, the Magic Kingdom.
You want to see who's going to play in the finals of this tournament? You can see it live. The winner of the tournament will play live, and you can see it. Go to the SchmoedownLive.com October 19th in Orlando.
Live from the Epcot Center next to the Body Wars exhibit.
Not true, but sounds good enough. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining us. For Mark Ellis, I'm Christian Harloff. See you next time.
Harloff's going for it.
He's going for the nuke. He's going for RMB's nuke, which I think is really great for RMB. But this could backfire. This is not a good idea.
Look, man, all you gotta do is go out there and win the team titles. That's it.
Oh, yeah, you gotta do is win the team titles. All I gotta do is win the titles. I've been trying to win the titles for 3 years. It's not as...
Hi, Emma.
I don't want to worry about this. I don't want to worry about that. Get your together. Snickers, let's go.
Good boy.
You owe another dollar.